My name is Luca Netz, and I'm a 25-year-old serial entrepreneur and CEO of Pudgy Penguins. Pudgy Penguins was a diamond in the rough type of brand, a failing company, but with massive upside if it was in the right hands. So my partners and I acquired it almost 18 months ago for $2.5 million. After 9 months of rigorous work, uphill battles, and trying to build a strong foundation for the brand to live on, we leveraged the success of our early growth and raised $9 million to build a globally recognized IP, leveraging the power of Web3 and digital ownership. Being a CEO is hard work, so I'll show you a day in my life running Pudgy Penguins. First thing we do is we email check. Spend about an hour, my first day email checking. Make sure my calendar's up top. That's what I got going for the day. I do my meetings from Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday, no meetings. I go from about 10 to 8 p.m. every Monday, just meetings, meetings, meetings. Luna, come on, show your scar. She just got part of her lung removed. She attacks on command, so she's like a complete defense war animal. Here we have the new addition to the family. His name is Chest. He's blind in both eyes. Sometimes when you are blessed to be able to take care of animals like this, you gotta do it. And here's our man of the residence. His name is Bandit. Now I'm gonna get them ready for a walk and walk them around the block. Do 3 walks a day, 15 minutes each. They get 45 to an hour outside. Every morning, I watch First Take. So I literally will get my breakfast, watch some First Take, some Stephen A. It takes about 30 minutes to get to the office.
Here's the first meeting of the day. It's with our head of growth, Austin, and we are discussing a huge quarter four toy rollout.
You know this better than anyone else. I've seen it in real time. If I agree with you, if spending money on ads is not the way, then it sounds to me like just creators and gifting and just endless seeding is the way. I will give you all of our inventory, you know? Like, the world is gonna see if we're proven at retail or not, dude. I gotta leave. Bye.
Just finished my meeting with Austin. It was great. We are adjusting some of our strategies for a more organic approach, and now I have meetings for the rest of the day.
I was talking to 1KX Peter. He was like, Luca, you're thinking too much 6 months and 12 months ahead. What is your 5-year and your 10-year plan? And I've been thinking about this long and hard. If we incubate characters and stories through NFTs, and you can do that at like a Disney-esque level, you're a $10, $15, $20 billion business. Why is a Facebook, who literally's whole plan is changing their name to Meta, they believe in the metaverse so much, what is really going to get their revenues driving is if they can sell those wearables, if they can sell those characters in those worlds. We are the character incubator for this metaverse, right? We are that avatar curator, that avatar creator, that storyteller there. When VCs are walking into houses in Austin and in New York and they see a collectible, that's where you get them.
Yeah,
and they get a GIF or they see an Instagram post, they see a YouTube and they see us in the press and in the headlines and on the YouTube. That's how, you know what I mean? Yeah. That's really the game I'm playing. Is just like, how much can
how
I
many
make
times
you
are
think
you seeing
about
us?
Me?
Yeah.
Right? So that when everyone has an abundance of cash and they're trying to pour their cash somewhere, they're pouring their cash here.
Yeah. You just have to keep pushing the narrative, keep pounding it every day.
It's your storytelling, brother. Your entrepreneurship storytelling now.
So now I'm doing a podcast with the CPG Club. Super excited to talk with them and explain some of our thought processes and theses.
GM, we are back. And do we have an amazing guest for you today?
I'm headed over to the Pudgy House to sync up with the team on some of the meetings that I had earlier today.
In the dog house.
Dude, literally, we got the Roomba though. So like Roomba comes and sweeps up every like day or
something.
I nuked all spend on Instagram growth, by the way.
Yeah.
I nuked it. It's done. I nuked it up until yesterday. I said no, zero budget, so no more Facebook ads, at least until Austin starts doing his thing. We talked long today, and then just to give you some context, and I could agree with this strategy, but he thinks we have to make it go organically viral before we do paid marketing, which means he's got to hire a bunch of creators. And I gave him the full green light to hire a bunch of creators. They should cost between $2,000 to $3,000 to $4,000 a piece, and he's going to hire a couple of them. And this, I think, this falls into the big marketing budget to make it successful, because if he can't, these things have to go viral organically for like any of this to work.
Did I tell you guys that John hit me up earlier today and he had a call with Nickelodeon? Actually got pushed back, but he told me he was gonna pitch Nickelodeon on behalf of us.
Sync up with the team went well, and now we're culminating our day with some Benihana.
Jennifer, come eat before Luca eats everything.
What's the best thing you think you do for your tiredness, like just being tired?
Not eat shit food.
That's what that is?
Yeah, you need to figure out what foods are making you slow.
Right.
Gluten for sure, dairy. You just stop eating that for a week and sugar, you're gonna feel really good.
Whoa.
Yeah. That's why I don't eat till like 2 or 3. I can't focus.
Apparently something happened to the blind wombat Chester, and I think he's getting his stomach pumped. This is really interesting though, for me. Like, on the surface, it seems like I'm very lucky. I'm not gonna say that I don't think like a greater power is at play here, like helping me and, you know, definitely rooting for me. But the universe always makes me go down the hardest path to get there. Like, I get there and it's amazing, and when you look back at the achievement, you're like, oh, whoa, that's phenomenal. But you don't see like the BS. Like, I'm basically on a 14-hour day at the beginning of an all-time great sprint. And as I'm wrapping up my day, having lunch with the team, you know, girlfriend calls me and says, something's going wrong with Chester. Go to the emergency room. And it's 9 o'clock. Been up since 7 a.m. working. And now 9 p.m. Gotta go to the hospital because Chester, little wombat, has something wrong. Story of my life.